In North America, we have numerous operations as Repsol. Our E&P business is a growth engine for Repsol here. However, our North American gas and power business is also a substantial growth engine for the business. Regarding E&P, we have operations in the United States as well as in Canada and also in Mexico. We have contracts that we satisfy to develop fields in Mexico that have been, let's say, at low levels of production for some time, but to bring them up to higher levels of production and sustain that production. In the United States, we're involved in the deepwater Gulf of Mexico, where we have been the operator on some leases, and we've also been just a participant. As an operator, we drilled the discovery well for the Buckskin prospect in the deepwater Gulf of Mexico. We have other acreage onshore Louisiana, where we'll be drilling a well next year. We have other acreage that we're in a joint venture with Sandridge in Oklahoma and Kansas, involving the development of the Mississippi and Lime play. Also, we're in Alaska. And in Alaska, we've been drilling wells here since early this year. Hopefully, the success of those wells will be known very soon, and we'll have much bigger developments coming up there. We're involved in other parts of Canada as well, offshore Newfoundland and Labrador, where with partners we'll be drilling a well sometime late this year, early next year. An exciting part of our business, though, is the North American trading and marketing, for which I'm responsible. And in North America trading and marketing, we've been growing as well. We entered into North America as Repsol with the Canaport LNG facility in order to move our LNG from international locations into what at the time was the most valuable and the most important market in the world for natural gas. We're still the largest market for natural gas in North America. At today's levels of pricing, however, we're not the most valuable, except our market. Our market from time to time, especially in the wintertime, can be the most valuable. This February, our pricing in our marketplace was the highest in the world. Even with all the prices you hear about the Far East, you look at the daily averages in February, we were the ones up at the top. In North America, with our Canaport LNG position and with our ability to bring LNG and serve the New England marketplace, we saw synergies with other parts of the market itself. And so with that in mind, we adopted a strategy in 2011, and we began to put that strategy into place. That strategy was to grow our business into other parts of North America, including the Mid-Continent area, including the Mid-Atlantic coast, the Southeast, the Gulf Coast, effectively everything on the eastern part of the United States and Canada, and in some instances growing all the way back to ACO. So our business plan now is to step out from just New England and get into the rest of North America and become profitable. When Repsol first started looking at Canaport LNG as a business, the worldwide prices were showing that North America had actually the highest and most valuable marketplace. Since then, we've had numerous things happen in the world, including an incredible increase in the price of oil. If you don't know, outside of North America, most prices are set on oil-based type structures. Therefore, the prices for LNG internationally went up. In the United States and in Canada, we had a shale boom. So the shale gas was being developed, and it was creating significant amount of supply and an oversupply of natural gas for North America. We became an energy island, so to say, for natural gas. And with that happening, our prices were down here while worldwide prices were very high. What that meant was that there was less LNG available to bring to the Canaport terminal. Doesn't make sense, even though you're paying fees to sustain your capacity in the pipelines as well as in the LNG facility, if prices in North America are only $4 or $5 per MMBTU, and you can get $16 to $20 in the international marketplace, that's where you need to put your gas supply. So we've been moving more and more into that area. However, as I mentioned earlier, our marketplace is very strong in the wintertime, and we still enjoy that benefit of bringing LNG into the marketplace and getting prices that are better than the rest of the globe.